The EI range of relay devices enables EI alarm systems to signal and control other devices when fire or carbon monoxide has been detected. These applications include notification to telecare systems, boiler shutdown, and for increased visibility and audibility in communal areas, garages and stables by activating additional strobes and sounders. The Ei428 is a 10-year mains-powered relay with rechargeable battery backup for wireless or wired connection to EI-compatible devices. The Ei428 provides a single electrically isolated set of contacts rated 5 amps for many switching or low-voltage signal applications. With the Ei428, you can select either continuous or pulse mode signaling. In continuous mode, the relay will switch and latch until a cancel signal is received. In pulse mode, the relay will switch for 5 seconds only. The default setting is continuous. A battery backup switch that is defaulted to the off position. The controlled device terminal block. The Ei428 230-volt mains power supply and wired interconnect terminal block. The Ei428 relay is primarily designed to work with RF devices, but for additional flexibility, it can also be used with wired interconnect systems. Unlike smoke or carbon monoxide alarms, the relay does not have a sensor and can therefore be placed near the device it is controlling. Wiring is easy. A normally open wired application means that the controlling device is disconnected in standby and will therefore become connected when the alarm system is activated. In the example shown, the strobe and sounder would be powered off until the alarm system is activated, and only then would they receive power through the relay. When the alarm condition has ended, power to the strobe and sounder will be once again removed. A normally closed NC wired application means that the controlling device is connected in standby mode and will become disconnected when the alarm system is activated. In the example shown, the boiler would be powered on, operating normally until the alarm system is activated, and only then would power or the ability for the boiler to operate normally be removed. When the alarm condition has ended, power for the boiler to operate normally will be restored. In each case, ensure that the battery backup switch is moved to the on position before completing the installation and replacing the cover. Wireless setup is quick and easy. For mains powered alarms, wire the 230 volt mains powered mounting plates. Insert the Ei3000 MRF wireless module. Feed the antenna into its guide through the aperture. Line up the module pins with receptor socket and gently push the module into the base of the alarm. Slide the alarm onto the mounting plate and you will hear a click to indicate the alarm has docked correctly. Insert a small, flat-headed screwdriver into the house code button. Press and hold until you see a solid blue light. Then immediately release. The alarm will indicate that it is in house code mode by flashing once every 5 seconds. Press and hold until you see a solid blue light, then immediately release. The alarm will indicate that it is in house code mode by flashing once every 5 seconds. Then enter house code mode on the relay. Insert a small flat-headed screwdriver into the house code button. Press and hold until you see a solid red light, then immediately release. The flash count will increase by 1 with the addition of each device. Confirm the number of flashes for your system on each device. Exit house code mode on the alarm. Press and hold until you see a solid blue light, then immediately release. Exit house code mode on the relay. Insert a small, flat-headed screwdriver into the house code button. Press and hold until you see a solid red light. Then immediately release. All flashing will cease. Test and commission the system. Press and hold the test button on the connected alarms and ensure that the controlled device has responded as expected. Releasing the test button will see the controlled device return to standby condition within a few seconds.